Now, intellectual property is property as an idea, innovation, or process that derives from the work of the mind, or intellect. So whatever is outcome of somebody's thoughtfulness or intellect is going to be called as intellectual property. Okay, so for example, songs, lyrics, then computer program, painting, new process to manufacture airbags, so anything you think and you document it or you create something is your intellectual property until you are developing something physical. When you develop something physical, that becomes your material property, right? If you would build a home, that is your material property. That is not your intellectual property. But if you just create a good design of a home or house, that can be your intellectual property, because that is only design. That is outcome of your mind and intellect. It is not not a physical thing. And most of the time, it is not a physical thing. Okay, but even the painting, if you see, painting is physical thing, but still it is a thought, right? In painting, what is there? Somebody's thought is going to be painted, right? So it comes under intellectual property. Now, problem with intellectual property is that it is hard to protect an idea. Until it is a form of idea, it is very hard to protect. Most of the time, you will find that you have good idea, you discuss with some of your friends. After some time, you will find that before you, they have implemented it. Okay, then IP laws protect the result of an idea. So there is IP laws, intellectual property laws, which can protect the result of an idea, not an idea. It can protect the result of an idea. That means, so you have an idea of how to you can say how to design a circuit for a particular lab, okay? Or say how to design all wireless switches in a particular house, right? So you have ideas. If your idea can be stolen in time, more laws are there because which can protect it. But if you can immediately document it, your idea, and get an intellectual property, some copyright on it, then you are going to be protected by the law. So, like many times it has happened with me, like a few years back, I was discussing with one of my friends that there is many businesses are coming up very fast, like Swiggy, then you will find Zomato, and like this, many online businesses are coming up, and then selling websites. So I was discussing that to what about if we can develop a tutorial match website, a tutor finding website. There is many students in the city, and Patna is a small city, but if you think about Kolkata, Mumbai, for students it is very hard to find out a good teacher in the near about, right? So I was discussing with him that how it can be possible, what kind of website can be developed. So immediately he catched up, and he had money and everything. So he developed a website, and right now he is running it properly. So this is what happens. If you have an idea, because nobody can protect it, it is going to be, most of the time it is going to be stolen, and you can't do anything. But if you can document it, and if you can get the result of your idea, then it is going to be protected by the IP laws. Okay, advocates of IP laws give some argument like it gives innovators a reason to innovate. They have a right to profit from their own labor. Definitely, right? Why does the innovator will innovate something new? By giving their hard work and intellect, day and night, innovators need to work to develop something new. So this IP Act gives a reason to them that why they will innovate by preserving their right to it. Okay? Without that protection, there is less incentive to innovate, right? So if this incentive is not given to them, there will be no reason of innovating new thing. And they will find in many fields, this is affecting very hardly. You can see that in the field of music. In previous days, you know, one good song, you know, it was very time-taking and lengthy process. And you will find, you know, everything was original in those musics, like starting from the instruments and voice and everything. And slowly what happened, due to this internet and all, people have started downloading the songs free of cost, right? And distributing this cost and sharing this intellectual property at free of cost. So due to that, this, you know, the original people who was, you know, giving their hard work and was using, you know, their intellect to, you know, create new songs, lyrics, so they got demotivated. Nowadays you will find these musics are coming, it is most of computer generated. It is developed within 1 month or 15 days, you will find most of the musics. Reason is the same thing. You know, nowadays who are developing, they know that we are not going to get enough incentive out of it. So it is going to run for a few days on, you know, TV channels and other from where we will get some money. So why should we give, you know, enough time behind it? So many, like this, you know, many other fields, you know, are going to be affected. Like you will find that still we are, you know, reading most of the books are old books, right? If you, you know, you will find a very less number of books are there which are, you know, getting published in this current subject or the latest subjects. Why? Reason is that nowadays, immediately I will publish a book, or I'll write a book, but the next day it will be available on the internet, and as an author, we are not going to get any incentive. Or, you know, whatever it is, as per, you know, it is not going to be as per the expectation or work, right? So that is decreasing the interest of people in writing good books. You'll find definitely new books are there, but you will not find a single book from a good author, good scientist, right? If you see your, you know, classic books what you have studied for your, you know, say for electrical people or electronics people, all the books was written before 90s or before 2000 at least, most of the books. And nowadays, whatever books are coming, you can see their quality, right? And none of the books are, you know, going to be properly recommended by any of the professors nowadays. And the reason behind that is the same, because people are getting less interest of writing a new good book. Sir. So there is many other fields, you know, the same things goes with. Then copyright. It applies to songs, computer program, books, artwork, or any work with an author. So if there is an author or some, you know, some creator of it, then it can have some, you know, copyright. Okay. But it can't have a patent, because only that time you will get a patent when some hardware is going to be possible to develop, you know, based on that. If it is not possible, like in a computer program, it is a software, so it can be patented. It will get, you know, copyright only. Like songs, you know, somebody writes a book, okay, some artwork, some design, or some painting or whatever, in any form, it is going to be copyrighted, okay. Now, the author or owner of the copyright controls, like who can make copies of the work, who can make derivative work from the original, that means like, you know, remixing it or based on the work or modifying this work, some new work can be designed or developed. So it can be controlled by the copyright holder. Now, who can perform the work publicly, like for songs or for some books? No, Can you take a book and read it out on the internet and just distribute the audio? Do you have this permission? Does the copyright of the book allows you to do it? Or say the book is in PDF format, but you created a video and you can say that the copyright was on the PDF, so I have converted it in video and I can circulate it on the internet. But it depends on the copyright of the book, how the copyright is implemented, described, license, copyright license is described in the book. Does it allow to reproduce something based on the book, right? Now, who can display your work publicly? Now, is it possible somebody can display the work, like a book or song or video, can publicly display, and like movies? So you have purchased a movie DVD, or you have purchased some subscription of Netflix. So can you redistribute your Netflix videos, or you can you make a video conference and can you play these movies? No, because your subscription is a personal subscription. You can't publicly distribute it or display it. Okay. Now, who can distribute the work? So that is also going to be defined in the copyright of a document or anything. Okay. That means whether the end user or end customer can distribute it or not, or any intermediate or who can distribute and in what way they can distribute. All these things are going to be described. Next, copyright protection lasts for the life of the original author plus 70 years. It is in USA. Okay. So this is based on US Act. Okay. What happens in India? It is almost similar. I will show you later. Okay. If the work is owned by publisher, the copyright can last for 95 years. Like, one of the example was, Happy Birthday to You song. There was a, copyright on this song. So for a long time, you will see in all movies and, previously in restaurant also, singing this song was avoided. And in most of the movies, you will not find in birthday scenes the people are singing this song. But nowadays, you will find in public gathering movies and everywhere this song is going to be played by the people. The reason is that these songs are rarely in movies and not sung at a restaurant because of the copyright. But this copyright was dispensed on 22nd 9 2015. So Happy Birthday song copyright is not valid to adjust rules in Los Angeles time. So on this date this Los Angeles time had reported that the judges have given a verdict that the copyright on the song is not valid. So from that time onwards, again, the people started using this song in movies and public places, restaurants and all. Okay. Then obtaining copyright protection. The act of creation gives something a copyright. So even your doodles or notes are copyrighted. Okay. You don't need this copyright symbol either. If you don't want to put on this symbol. Okay. Now, if the work is going to be shoot commercially registered for a copyright. Now, here is, sometimes you can use a small piece of a copyrighted work without permission. Like you will find that in YouTube videos, many songs, usually, if in your YouTube video, if you put a full song or, more than, 1 minute or 5 seconds, I think, more than 5 seconds, YouTube will send you a copyright message that you have used somebody else's copyrighted work in your video, okay? And if you use for less than 5 seconds of a song, then it is going to be permitted. So you will find that in many videos, they keep part of either video or song or audio for very fraction of second or 2 seconds, 3 seconds, right? Because that is permissible, okay? Guidelines are not well defined even. Depends upon purpose of the use, nature of copyright work, amount of work copied, effect of the use of potential market. Okay. Now, Digital Millennium Copyright Act, this is an act quite globally accepted and followed. Right. In 1998, to extend copyright law to digital technologies, this law came out. So, illegal to circumvent technologies that enforce copyright, game requiring you to be connected to the internet. So this kind of issues was coming up this time, because this time internet was just growing, and it is also called as a safe harbor, because limits the liability of online service provider. YouTube does not liable for someone posting a copyrighted movie. Now, say today you post new movie on your YouTube channel. So then you are going to be responsible for that. The movie owner, if the movie owner launch a case, it will be against that user who have posted. It is not going to be against YouTube. Okay. Then not everyone likes this DMCA, this Digital Millennium Copyright Act. Because users are unhappy with the DCMA, Electronic Forensic Foundation and other feels the DMCA limits freedom of speech, right? Then we can't let John Deere destroy the very idea of ownership. This is some article, then everyone hates the DMCA. This is another article. So I'm not going into them right now. Then Creative Commons. Creative Commons gives the attributed this copyright acts and licenses. Okay, so offers alternative to copyright license that is less restrictive than traditional copyright, like our textbook. So this Creative Commons license are having less amount of restriction, and anybody I develop a node, so I can put a Creative Commons license on it. Okay, for that I don't need to do much. I just put any of this license on my document, so that people can understand what I want. Okay, so first one, if you see on many document you will find CC, then one person, and it is written by. That means it is copyrighted and you can use it by giving attribution. That means if you are going to use, then you must attribute, that means you must cite my name and detail of this document and everything, okay? That it is whose work you are doing. Now, other can copy, distribute, display, perform, and remix your work if they credit your name as requested by you. Then another is I will find here by, but you are putting another condition, SA. SA means share alike. What does it mean? Other can distribute your work only under a license identical to the one you have chosen for your work. Right? That means whatever permission you have given, if somebody is using your work, after giving you proper attribution, they have to use the same attribution. That means if you have put it something that is non-commercial, then the who is regenerating or developing something new based on this work, they have to do the same thing, same license they have to put on their new work. Okay, then you can see here dollar and cross. The NC, that means non-commercial attribution and not non-commercial. That means other can copy, distribute, display, perform, or remix your work, but for non-commercial purpose only. Okay. Next is you can see here ND, that means no derivative works. Okay, that means it have to, whoever is using your document, they have to give attribution. At the same time, other can only copy, distribute, display, or perform verbatim copies of your work. Okay, so they can't remix it. Okay, they can't twist, or they can't change any of your document. They can copy it, distribute it, display it, perform it, but they can't modify it or can't develop a new work based on this. Okay. Next is, you can see here, non-commercial and share alike. If this is there, then whoever is using your work, they have to again make their work non-commercial as well as share alike. Okay, then here you can see non-commercial and non-derivative. That means if you put this on any on your work and you distribute it, then whoever is using your document, they have to attribute you. Then they can't make use of it in commercial way. The use must be in non-commercial and no derivative. That means whoever is using it can't remake it or can't modify it. Okay, so you can see these are collaborative commons. So like, you know, most of the time we download images, document from internet, and we don't care. Most of the time people don't care about what is the license of this, and do we have permission to use of these documents for personal use, or sometimes, you know, putting on a website. You will find many website there are images which are just downloaded from the internet. But does the people check before using or reusing it for their personal purpose or commercial purpose, developing something new, some new design, whether they have proper attribution or proper license, or proper copyright they have checked out? So if I want to show you, I can show you some examples. If we go to, say, google.com, sorry. Okay, say we want to just get some tiger's image and for some of our website use or some personal use, or we want to put it on our desktop background. Okay, the tiger image. Okay, so you can see here, if we simply search it, there is many images, and say somebody like one of them, so this one, to peruse and for their personal whatever requirement is there. Okay, now go to this. Okay, click on this. Okay, now how to check or how to find out the license of these images, before use, you can be sure about whether it is it allow you to use for commercial purpose, use for personal purpose, can you modify this, can you change the color of it. Okay, so how we can do this? Okay, so for that, just a minute. Okay, so there is actually in this browser, I am not finding that. Here there will be advanced search, and there you can select, but In the here you can see here this license level are coming on the this. Click on this. Okay. If you click on this, you can open this. You can see here license detail. Okay. If I want to go to the license detail, you can see the Shutterstock license agreement is here. Okay. So you can see all this license agreement, whatever, in what way you can use it, what it provided for you. So this is not a Creative Commons commons license. You can see this one, okay. But some of them are with the Creative Commons license are there. You can see. Users right here you will find this. Now this menu is coming under this. Yes, so you can see here Creative Commons license. Okay, so now these pictures are coming which are having Creative Commons license. Okay, because Creative Commons license allow you to reuse these images with either by giving attribution, by give, the license defines I have already discussed in that slide. Okay, now if I go to this license detail. See, this image, from that image is having what? CC attribution and share alike. Okay, is having CC attribution and share alike. When you share, everyone wins the whatever dollar is there. So you understand. So what the share alike means? If you remix, transform, or build upon the material, you must distribute your contribution under this same license as original. Understand? That means what was our remix? Sorry. If you just say you enhance this image and you just change some of the color and something you have done, then you can't own it. You have to again redistribute it without putting any new condition on this. And what condition you can put? What condition you can put? The same condition, CC, attribution, and share alike. Understand? So this is the thing we need to understand when we are downloading images or whatever other document from the internet. Okay. Then comes patent. Protection from someone who creates, protection for someone who creates a new product or process. You can see carefully. If you are creating a product or a process, it can have patent. Okay, then it is not under copyright anymore. Patent holders has the right to exclude others from making, using, offering, for sale, or selling the invention. So you say you have developed a new circuit, as I was telling you, say how all the switches can be made, converted to Wi-Fi switches in a house. And if you can develop a new way of doing it, then that you can have a patent. Okay, and you can, at the time being a patent owner, you can control or you can exclude others from reproducing or making, using, of offering for sale or selling the invention. Okay, so you can restrict all this thing. Now US patent lasts for 20 years. Okay, must apply for patent must be original, useful, and non-obvious. So these are the things before applying for patent people should keep in mind. Next come trademark. So It is what can be a trademark. Trademark can be a word, it can be a phrase, it can be a logo, it can be some shape or sound that identifies the source of goods or services. So you can see here, you know, a big list of trademark, right? Now, you will find again two things in trademark. One is you will find that in R is written, like in LinkedIn, you will find it is R. But if you go to Google, you will find TM. So it is common law trademark. That means it will be written TM. But if it is a registered trademark, it will be written R. Okay. Privacy. The ability to control information about oneself. Information systems have eroded personal privacy in the United States. So this is just it is same in India. So but it gives the balance between consumer protection and commerce. Okay. In Europe, European Union consider privacy a fundamental right for authorized customer. Now, privacy legislation, there is a few very important and worldwide followed laws. One is called COPPA, that is Children's Online Privacy Protection Act. Okay. What is this? Organization need to make an effort to detect someone's age prior to accessing a website. So this is the reason you will find when you go to access any website, the first question they ask that, are you 18 plus? You need to make yes, then only they will allow to enter you in the website, right? Then Family Education, Educational Rights and Privacy Act, that is APRPA, that protects the student records in the universities. If this act is not there, then you will find the all the universities and schools are selling out the students' data, okay? And they are gaining more than selling data, from the tuition fees. Then another important act is Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act, or HIPAA. Okay. It protects the patient's records.